The Eiffel Tower is 300 metres, 65 centimetres high, 324 metres if you include the antenna spire. That's over three times the height of Big Ben. So how was the Eiffel Tower built and why? For the World's Fair in Paris in 1889, a competition was launched to design a tower that would be the tallest structure in the world, stretching 1,000 feet into the sky. To find out why we're scared of heights, click James's video here. Anyway, some engineers working under a guy called Gustave Eiffel came up with a plan to design a metal frame structure. And probably because Eiffel was such a big name in the world of engineering at the time, they won the competition and construction on the tower started in early 1887. First up, they had to lay the foundations, and this involved creating 2 metre thick concrete slabs under each of the feet and putting them 7 metres underground. Now, because two of the feet actually bordered on the River Seine, the engineers were worried that water would seep in, so they created metal shoe structures that basically kept the waters at bay. Next up, they constructed the legs, but they needed to make sure that they built them simultaneously, because otherwise they could have ended up with the Leaning Tower of Paris. Now, to do this, they used hydraulic jacks under each of the different legs, raising and lowering them to make sure that the first floor was completely horizontal. So finally, they had to create the main body of the tower, and to do this, they shipped in 18,000 different parts that were prefabricated in a factory. And they put them together on site using 2.5 million rivets. Now, as the body of the tower grew up in size, they had to actually get them up there somehow. So they did this using creeper cranes, which ran up the legs of the tower. And interestingly, the guide shafts of the creeper cranes are actually the ones that are used today in the elevators that zip you up to the top. Just over 2 years after construction started, the tower was completed on the 31st of March 1889, and Gustave Eiffel was actually the first person to climb all 1,710 steps all the way to the top, where he unfurled the French flag, the tricolour. Now, fair enough that he was the first person to do that, because he'd actually invested a shedload of his own money. But that investment paid off, because from his apartment, actually on the tower, he watched 2 million visitors just in the first year alone, which equated to about $1 million worth in ticket sales. Now, the tower was initially called the Pylon of 320 metres, then the 320 metre tower, then the Tower of Mr. Eiffel, and finally the Eiffel Tower or the Tour d'Eiffel. But Parisians initially didn't really like it. They thought it was a bit of an eyesore on the Paris landscape. Plus, some of them even thought it would topple over and crash down on their homes. But considering this tower was supposed to be dismantled pretty much straight after it was built, it's lasted really well, and it was actually the tallest structure in the world for 40 years, and of course now is a real icon of Paris. Now, building the Eiffel Tower is all very well, but imagine building an elevator all the way into space. Click here if you want to see that video, or if you want to see my favourites, click here.